firstly, Happy New Year and many congratulations.
Thanks a lot. Yes. Happy, wishing you a very Happy New Year too.
Yep, and your fans are very happy. So, पहले मैं कमेंट्स करती हूँ जो आपके वीडियो के साथ आए थे. फर्स्टली, अरमान नेवर फेल्स टू मेस्मराइज मी. दिस इज वन ऑफ द फैंस. दिस मैन मेक्स अस हैप्पी थ्रू द हार्ड टाइम्स. द अदर कमेंट इज, अरमान यू हैव शोन कि हम किसी से कम नहीं. अनदर कमेंट, यूनिवर्सल ट्रुथ, अरमान वॉइस इज ब्यूटिफुल फॉर ऑल लैंग्वेजेस. एंड देन द अदर कमेंट इज, अरमान इज नॉट योर टिपिकल आइकॉन, ही इज अ म्यूजिशियन एंड अ ट्रू आर्टिस्ट. ऐसे जब आप कमेंट्स सुनते हो तो कैसा लगता है?
I have no words to describe how I feel. Firstly, I think I'm very thankful and grateful that I have such a strong army of fans called the Armanians. I think unke support ke wajah se hi, you know, I am where I am today. And people only dream of having such a fan base and such, you know, strong fans who are so active and so supportive of everything I do. So I would just want to start by saying that I'm so thankful and grateful that I have this bunch of amazing cute people who follow me, give me so much love and support me.
And wo hi hai na, aapke fans mere farre paper, I fall short of paper. जब क्वेश्चन जब उनके लिखने होते हैं इतने सारे आते हैं. सो फर्स्टली यू, इट्स योर फोर्थ इंग्लिश
सोलो सिंगल.
या एंड आई हर्ड इट एंड इट्स वेरी वेरी सूदिंग. एंड वो जैसे द कोल्ड ऑफ पेरिस में जैसे वार्म सा मिल रहा है. सो आई ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू नो एंड दे ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू नो, दो साल इस जेम को, राज को कैसे छुपा के रखा था?
अभी मैं हर रात को before sleeping I used to listen to this song on loop and always wish ki yaar ye kab release ho. Thode gaano ki actually ek destiny hoti hai ki yaar, you know, kab release hote hain, when do they, you know, go out into the world. And I think is gaane ki destiny ye thi ki it releases in 2022. Ye 2020 mein control ke saath saath hi it was ready. It was in my phone. It's been stored in my phone since almost 2 years. And usko har raat sunta tha main and sochta tha yaar kab release karunga main. Lekin finally it's out there. It's something that I've always wanted to put out. It's a song that's very close to my heart. And I know I say that about all my songs, but this one is extremely special and extremely close to my heart. And I feel it's one of my strongest English songs to date. From what I have put out, and a lot of people feel that same way. And video, to I've, you know, honestly, I myself, I'm in love with the video. Sometimes, you know, you create a song and you're always worried about ki yaar video kaise banega, how will it, you know, really justify the song that I've put out. Lekin this song is truly an extension of the audio. The video is a complete extension of the audio and it truly describes the feelings in the most apt way possible. So all in all, ye gana, audio, video, I'm super happy with it. And I'm just so happy with the way it's been received so far. Everyone has been, you know, loving it. It's just been, 3 days now? And it's doing so well online and it's gotten so much love. So yeah, I'm just super, super very like I've not been able to sleep in the last few days. Meko neend hi nahi aa rahi, itni excitement ho rahi hai just about
awesome. This awesome. So and you know what is the other thing that's excited your fans now?
What is that?
Tumka,
oh, I've got the girl.
Yeah,
I knew.
Finally.
So it's I've broken the tradition of not getting the girl in my music videos. Har ek music video mein mereko ya to ladki chhod ke chali jati hai ya hamare dono ke beech mein kuch problems hote hain or there's something that's amiss. But in this one I am with the girl, I get the girl, the girl is with me, kahin nahi ja rahi hai, fans are happy.
Totally. So
actually it should be reverse. They should be unhappy if the girl is not with me. But they are like, they got fed up with seeing me always sad and always like at the end of the video waiting ki yaar mujhe kab meri wo love of my life will be with me. So finally I think they're happy that I have got the girl in the video.
You know, I think they're like your true fans. You know, they say that you are happy when your loved one gets his loved one. I think the wo feel hai unko.
ये वाली फील है.
वो वाली फील है. पर आई वांट टू आस्क यू, जैसे यू नो आई आस्क अ लॉट ऑफ संस्टार्स कि फ्राइडे एंजाइटी सबको होती है, कोई रिव्यू नहीं पढ़ता है, कोई अपना फोन स्विच ऑफ कर देता है, कोई प्रेफर्स नॉट गेटिंग अप फ्रॉम वन साइड ऑफ द बेड. व्हाट इज इट लाइक फॉर यू ऑन द ईव ऑफ द रिलीज ऑफ योर सिंगल और एन एल्बम?
आई एम यूजुअली वेरी नर्वस, एक्सट्रीमली नर्वस, इवन फॉर यू आई वॉज, बट somewhat less nervous than I was with the other songs. I don't know why. I've just been so confident with the song and the sound and the way the video was and just everything. I think in the last 2 years, I've put out like 5 songs in English, and I've never been so sure of any song as much as I've been of you. And it's just one of those songs that make you want to listen to it again and again. And me as the artist of the song, someone who's put out the song myself, I am obsessed with the song. I don't know how. It's one of those songs that I keep listening to even today, even if it's out, it's released. Mera kya hota hai, ek bar ek release ho gaya gana, so I stop listening to it because then I start disconnecting and I'm like, yaar, bahut sun liya, I don't want to hear it. But this is one of those songs that I think I will carry with me till the very end. I think it's one of those forever kind of songs. And when an artist himself is obsessed with his own creation, I think that is a sign that there's something in the creation or something in the song. So
absolutely.
I'm truly madly obsessed with this song and with everything that it represents.
So you can't blame your fans also to be. And another question is, you've achieved a lot, touch wood, and many more. I would say that the journey has just started. But to be an icon, to be someone that everyone looks up to, it, do you sometimes get performance anxiety or are you anxious? Because with everything, it's up the ante. You cannot go down. It only has to go up and up and up. Does that sometimes get to you?
If you let it. I think just the way I am wired, I have a very, very strong... I don't know. I have these blinkers. I just do my own thing. And there's a lot of noise around me, but I don't pay attention to it. I remember I had written this quote that I don't want to be in the sea of my stardom. I want to watch it from the shore.
Wow.
I think somewhat on those lines. I don't know the exact words I used, but something on these lines that I don't want to be amidst it. I want to watch it from afar. I want to be happy watching it from afar, because if I'm too closed, I'll drown in it. And I don't want to do that. So I think that's what I follow in my life. You know, it's very rare for someone at my age to have achieved what I've done. And I think a lot of it has to do also with the blessings, the luck. There are all those factors. If people deny that, I think they'll be fools. There is... Obviously, there's a lot of hard work, a lot of, lot of mehnat that goes into becoming someone. But I also do believe that, you know, you need that stroke of luck. You need a sprinkle of that divine blessing on you. And I'm grateful that I've got that support from the universe, from people around me, that I've been able to achieve what I have achieved. And for me, I don't take anything for granted. Whatever I've achieved is... anyone else could, you know, also achieve that. So it's just everyone is capable of becoming a star. It's just about how you handle being a star is what keeps you a star. Is what I feel.
Totally, yeah. Totally. Ab main zara fan ke questions le do, nahi to na meri pitai hogi. So one of them has written. And
let's,
I think,
start.
Let's start. Yaar, itne dekho page. एक किताब बन सकती है बाय द एंड ऑफ इट, मे बी आई शुड प्रेजेंट इट टू यू वन डे, कंपाइलेशन. सो श्वेता हैज आस्क्ड, इट्स काइंड ऑफ क्लीशे बट इट्स ट्रू, इट्स नेक्स्ट टू मी एंड विद यू, इट्स द सेम लाइन. व्हाट वाज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर लाइन?
ओह या, there's a line that is very similar in next to me and in you, which is the it's kind of cliche. I don't know. It just came naturally. So Natania, who's the co-writer of both the songs with me, and she's collaborated with me on quite a few songs. We've written, co-written together on many of these English songs. And हमने कभी ये सोचा नहीं था कि यार ये next to me में है. It just happened to be so that we made the song and we're like, wait, that's also in next to me, the same line.
Yeah.
But I think it's cute in both the songs. It has its own meaning, and there was no like deliberate or intentional usage of that line.
Aditi and a whole lot of fans have, again, as in the comments, thanked you for saving them. And it's really nice because music heals. And if your fans actually feel they're going through healing, because everyone's going through a bad time, I think it's the best kind of compliment, you know. So I had to repeat this again. And Siddhika ne wants to know, handsome Malik ki appearance kyun nahi hui? Unka song debut kab ho raha hai? Waise hai kahan handsome Malik?
Handsome, he's actually with my mom and dad. But हाँ उसको भी एक गाने में we should definitely try to feature. Let's hope we can do that. Hopefully soon. आपने बहुत अच्छा idea दे दिया मुझे.
Totally. And since they're all happy, you got the girl. And so Lagna has asked, but if one of your fans proposed, फिर आप क्या करोगे?
क्या हुआ?
If one of your fans was to propose, तो कब तो क्या करोगे आप?
Propose to me?
तब क्या करोगे?
पता नहीं. I'll be in a fix. I don't know. How I would tackle
इतने सारे होंगे
क्या करूंगा मैं.
Shweta has asked, and also a lot of others have asked this, anything that was difficult part of this song while composing and shooting it, and your experience in Paris, which even KR has asked.
The difficult part, I think, would not be from a musical standpoint. I think what was difficult was definitely filming the song, the music video. We shot this in I think around November, December, and it was very, very cold in Paris. And you know how cold Europe and Paris gets in these months. So it was almost like what, 3 degrees, and I was shooting the song, and I was literally freezing. And we had just 24 hours to shoot the video because I was leaving the next day for Mumbai. And a few days after that, even France went into lockdown. So it's unbelievable that we've even been able to, you know, shoot a video and come back. The tough part, I would say, is that I had no plan of, like, I had no clue who was going to shoot the video, who was the director, who was the team, because I was going to Paris for a private gig. And I was like, you know, I'm in such a beautiful city. Why not shoot a music video? We have such a great backdrop. It's a romantic city. Why not shoot one of my romantic songs ka video here? And that one idea happened. And within 48 hours, we put together a whole crew from France, from Paris. We got a model who was from France again. And in 48 hours, the whole team was locked. Everyone was ready to shoot the music video. It's probably the fastest planned and executed song ever for me in terms of a music video. And I was very, very scared and nervous because firstly, everyone was talking in French. So I didn't understand anything about what. The director, thankfully, was not French. She was Russian and she happened to speak in English. So she was the one I was communicating the most with to understand what I'm supposed to do and how to act and stuff like that. But it was, I was very nervous because I was not understanding. And kya ho jata hai ki aap ek jab aap ek video karte ho, music video, so you always want to be comfortable to be able to perform. So you want to have your team, your crew, the people who you know, you're familiar with. And aisa kuch nahi tha. Main Paris mein tha. I don't even know the city that well. I had a whole crew that I had no idea. I didn't have know anyone from there. My dad was there with me on the trip, so he thankfully was helping me through the shooting process. But I think the most difficult part was getting the shoot done in 24 hours. And because there were multiple locations, there were some locations near the Eiffel Tower, some were in the bedroom, some were in the house, and some were on under the bridge, you know, where you're running and coming, some of those sections. So just doing all of that within a 24 hour period was really challenging.
Awesome. And, you know, that's it. So it's basically all about you, no? You're universal. Language is no barrier.
Yeah.
Continents are no barrier when it comes
exactly.
to your language.
Exactly. So, which is why when I finished and completed the shoot, I realized this one thing, that nothing is impossible at
Absolutely.
All.
Absolutely. Totally. And Shweta and all the rest also want to know, how does you describe you?
How do I describe you? Okay.
How does you describe you? You. There's a lot of you. Are you like anything like...
Okay, okay. They're using my puns now. I think You is a very, very, very personal, intimate song. And I feel every person has a you in their life. That you could be anyone. It could be your lover. It could be your pet. It could be your grandparent. You know, I think obviously the emotion of the song, the lyrics specifically are in the love and the romance space. But I feel your person that you are, you know, you have so much love for, and you feel is, this is my home. This person is my home, and this person is my my forever person. And that is the emotion that the song represents. That is what You is all about. And I think all of us have experienced that feeling of feeling that another human is someone so, so important for us. You know, it's not that our existence is dependent on that person. It's not that. That's a very different thing. Is that this person makes me feel everything that I want to feel. This person makes me feel loved, cared. This person makes me feel life is beautiful. This person makes me believe in love. And this is the exact emotion. This is the exact crux of the song. So for whoever's asked that question, that is what You is about.
And you are that you to your fans. And
am I?
Of course. Like rapid fire, I pile. So it says getting the girl or not. What would you prefer?
Getting the girl. For sure. Do think everyone thinks that I'm happy with not getting the girl, but honestly,
you have to change that.
It's because of Amal and all the other writers who have done compositions earlier for me in my Hindi singles. They've always written songs in which it's adhura pyar. So now it's not my fault. They have written such beautiful songs, but the songs are conceptualized.
Koi saazish hai.
Amal doesn't want to give me to get the girl in the video. Simple. But yeah, I would definitely choose getting the girl in the video.
Shooting a video in Mumbai or out?
It depends, but I would prefer to shoot outside of Mumbai.
Early morning shoots or night shoots?
That's a tough one, but early morning is fine. Yeah.
Shooting with known people or unknown people?
Now I can't say that because honestly, I've shot with unknown people and I've loved it. So both is fine. Anything is fine.
Cool.
Shooting with challenges.
True. I think next aapko na apne fan club ke saath shoot karna chahiye. You should just have to dekhna kitna achha banega. Can do that, yeah?
Yeah, and, great one.
Dekho, main aapko kitne ideas de rahi hun. So Palak has, I want to know what are your other collaborations adding to which? Khushi wants to know when will we see you and your brother together.
I'm actually planning a single of mine and Amal together. You know, we've never featured together in a song where it's a non-film single. And I'm planning that soon. So yeah, hopefully, fingers crossed, that happens soon.
True. Aur, next collaboration kya hai? Bahuton ko aap aur BTS ka collaboration dekhna hai. Chalo, manifest kar dete hain ye bhi.
Manifest kar lo. Main to chahta hi hun ki ho. I mean, I've always, you know, loved the boys, and I feel like, you know, if it's meant to happen, it'll happen. Getting a hold of them, they're global superstars. So,
aap kisi se kam nahi ho.
Yeah, but I would definitely love to collaborate with them and collaborate with a host of other artists in the West. And bahut sare already planned kar raha hu main, so get ready.
So somebody also wants to know, if I have missed out the name, I'm sorry. Which is one Indian female singer you would want to collaborate with on an English song?
Sorry, can you say that again?
Indian female singer you would want to collaborate with for an English song.
Indian female singer?
Ji.
That's interesting. I think Jonita Gandhi and Nikita Gandhi would be... these are two singles that I feel are really, really cool when it comes to English kind of like tonalities.
Nice. And I know we gave a lot of importance to, I remember asking Mr. Bachchan once, ki Hindi movies ka Oscar nahi milta. He says, tumhe Hollywood ke American award se kya lena dena hai, we get enough validation in our own country.
Yeah.
Similarly, with Grammys we hear, you know, inclusivity nahi hoti hai, everyone's not recognized. What is your personal take on awards and stuff like that as a singer? Because you are a global singer. What is your take? Because I'm very curious to know, because we give that stamp of approval after you've got, I know it's the biggest award. I know it's the biggest music award. But yeah. Is that important?
I mean, honestly, we've all grown up dreaming of one day winning a Grammy. So it it is somewhat of a dream for every artist to win one. And but it's not the be all or end all of things. It's I would say the love of fans is far superior than any awards. Being able to stand on a stage, selling out an arena, and your fans singing the lyrics of your songs back to you, that's the biggest award in the world.
Absolutely.
There is no greater feeling than that, no greater high than that. Yes, winning an award and being appreciated and recognized on a global level, like being recognized at the Grammys by the Recording Academy and similar such awards, is definitely something that I'm also looking forward to as an artist. And I've since I was a child, I've been looking forward to these things. All musicians grew up, you know, living that dream. But having said that, I wouldn't say that that is the only thing that one should always strive for. So for me as a musician, the fact that I have so many fans and so many listeners who just wait with their bated breath for my songs, content, pictures, videos, whatever I put out, I think that is the award in itself. That's it. That's nothing else is more important.
Because I really wanted to know, because last year was a lot of fans that are heartbreak across. You know, kabhi kabhi hota hai, inclusive nahi hai, we hamara, like BTS and they were.
No, I do see that a lot of Asian artists have not been able to successfully you know, achieve those places where you know, they deserve to be at. But I think it'll change. It is changing. It is already changing. The fact that BTS has become the biggest force to reckon with in the world of pop music, being a Korean act and being an Asian act, and actually, you know, giving all the other artists a run for their money, I think it's just, it's beautiful to see that an Asian act and artist can do that. It gives people like us a lot of faith as well, and hope that Indian artists also will be able to achieve that one day. And I hope to achieve that one day. I'm sorry.
Bhool mat jana. You will. Bhool mat jana. Pehle interview mereko dena.
Kabhi. Kabhi nahi bhoolunga. Main abhi tak kuch bhi bhoola hu main. Kuch bhi.
Nahi.
Then bas. Aage bhi nahi bhoolunga.
Wo mujhe pata.
Aapne keh diya to matlab hona hi hai. Don't worry.
I am going to say a prayer for you. And before we wrap, and let me tell you one thing. The other day we were discussing the BTS fandom. So someone, a music writer, actually said that you may discuss the BTS fandom, but we have the Arman Malik fandom here that is equivalent to that. So you can't say only them having the kind of fandom that they have. We have that growing in our own country too. And
that's so sweet. Thank you.
Cheers to you.
Glad to hear that. I'm sure the Armanians will be very happy hearing that.
They're very happy and they're very positive people. Sabne likha hai. उनको बोलो हमें बर्थडे विश करें, अब सबका बर्थडे आप ऐसा करो पूरे साल में जो सबका बर्थडे जस्ट है एवरी अरमानी.
I try to wish all of them a happy birthday, but I don't know, I think there's so many fans, how many do I wish, but ये लो सबके अभी नेक्स्ट 6 महीने में जिसके भी बर्थडे हैप्पी बर्थडे.
आदमी 6 महीने में कुछ और हमें देने वाले हैं, ये तड़कता भड़कता. And house tour भी उनको चाहिए, वो एक और demand है उनकी, वो भी पूरी कर दो.
Actually, फिलहाल I am in my new house and this is my studio room, which has my control का platinum plaque behind. But yeah, जल्दी house tour करूँगा मैं, and don't worry, I will show you all the amazing spaces in my new house.
So how about you dedicating some of you to your fans before we?
Okay, go. Let's go.
Yeah.
All my friends talk about the night we met, can't remember what. I was close to death with you in that perfect dress, knowing that it's heart or head and breaking all the rules. Just like don't fall in love before I know your name. Holding out hoping that you feel the same. No, I've never been one for sounding cliche, but it's true. All I do is think about you. All I do is think about you. All I do is think about how your leap of faith made me put all my faith in you. So all I do is think about, all I do is think about, all I do is think about you. All I do is think about, all I do is think about you. How long I can't wait until I get to say I do. So all I do is think about you.
Awesome. This is so lovely. And this is a song for all seasons. कभी कभी होता है ना एक बारिश टाइप का गाना है, एक विंटर टाइप का गाना है, इसमें ऑल सीजंस का वाइब है. मोर पावर मैन,
थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक
यू, देयर यू गो फ्रॉम स्ट्रेंथ टू स्ट्रेंथ. या एंड मोर प्लैटिनम डिस्क टू यू. एंड वेल, फिंगर्स क्रॉस फॉर एवरीथिंग दैट वी डिस्कस्ड.
फिंगर्स क्रॉस, लेट्स डू
इट. थैंक यू सर. यस, एग्जैक्टली, लेट्स डू इट. थैंक यू. बाय बाय, टेक केयर.